right, so next speaker. There is one conference that really is amazing. I don't know if people talk about TED or, but for me, the best conference that I think around is a DLD, when I think about something that is not strictly technology, you know, it's something more, it's a broader topic, it's about creativity, it's about art, it's a mix, it's a very interesting combination of all these topics. It's an invitation-only company, conference. Do you know DLD? All right, cool. So I show you what DLD is before to introduce you the next guest. Roberto, can you just launch the video if it's possible for you? Okay?
One idea is to try and cover and get update from the best minds in the industry.
The group of people that Berta manages to connect with and assemble here is really quite phenomenal.
Here at DLD, it's common that amazing people that will change the world or have changed the world are here.
Right. 15 hours of video content every minute on our site.
So not only is it growing fast, it's growing faster, and it's coming at us faster.
We're already up from 1.2 million users in October to over 2 million users now, just a few months later.
I think it's a huge opportunity now.
It's this platform that enables places really to have like a sense of memory.
How does a human body think thoughts, play a piano, kill germs, remove toxins, and make a baby all at the same time?
I was looking at the world from a genome-centric view.
So that we become increasingly insular.
Actually, I'm a professional climber.
Information wants to be expensive because it's so valuable.
How will advertising develop in future? Where will it go to?
The new wunderkammer is the software.
How do you define the spirit of a place?
Every second we are recasting the reality.
Technology is great, but it has to serve the humanity and the emotion.
Human beings are multidimensional beings. So other dimensions are completely forgotten in the architecture of economics.
The legal solution is presenting something that is simple enough so that basically people can understand it.
You always need the main governments backing you in whatever you do.
Cool as that, huh? Unbelievable. So, it's the last time I ask you this, and yesterday I forgot that in English the word is the same, so I prepared a poster. Can you read this poster there? Okay. There is behind this conference a woman, and she is unbelievable, really. And is here, I think it's the first time she's coming in Italy to talk in this kind of event, and I really need your help, guys. Steffi Czerny, co-founder of DLD and DLDWomen. Welcome, Steffi. Here we are. All right. How did you do that? I mean, Lady Gaga or the Nobel Prizes, how did you do that?
It's very simple. Being a curious housewife. Okay. You get them all. Just be nice, be curious, and supportive in the ego of stars.
Okay, okay.
Stars always have an ego, and if you're nice to them, it's an easy one to get them.
But tell me, when you started, yesterday was Yossi here,
yeah.
And when you launched DLD, no one obviously knew it, so you started from scratch and you have to invite some amazing guests and convince them to come. So where did you start from?
I tell you, I discovered technology and the internet in 95. Okay. 95 was the beginning of everything we are talking right now about.
Yeah.
And my boss, Hubert Börder from Börder Media, sent me the curious housewife to San Francisco saying, oh, we are a traditional print company, but I have the feeling something is going on in Silicon Valley, okay, which will affect our business. And he sent me the curious housewife who had no idea about technology, and by the way, I still have no idea about technology, and to explore what's going on. And I met a young man, blonde, tall, a little bit fat, and he was obsessed. This guy was really obsessed. He invented a thing we all know now, a browser. His name was Mark Andreessen.
Wow.
He was maybe 22, 23, and he was obsessed with this new technology. And the browser made it possible that images, not only text, was communicating over the net. And we still use the browser.
Right.
And this was the beginning. Mark Andreessen introduced me to Mitchell Baker, who was the law officer of Netscape then, and now she is president of Firefox. And so it's you know, it's a community. And then, if you like to host events, I like to host dinner parties. Okay. I thought maybe I should start a kind of a dinner party in Europe, because I was at a wonderful dinner party in 96 in Monterey. It was called TED, Technology Entertainment Design. It was the second or third TED, and I was impressed about all these people who came 96 to Monterey talking about their business, about their life, and so, and this was the beginning.
But tell me one thing, you guys, you saw in the video a lot of names, you know, like Mark Zuckerberg, Arianna Huffington, really, really a lot of names from, I would say, every sector, yeah. not strictly technology. But the thing that is interesting, I think, is that they arrived at DLD before they were famous, you know? So the difficult thing is to spot those talents before they're famous. So I think Mark Zuckerberg, how many users he has?
He was so proud when he was at DLD. He had he reached the 2 million point. 2 million, and he was really proud. Mentioning Mark Zuckerberg. Mark Zuckerberg is a classical example for this nerd. Mark, you can't hardly speak with Mark anything else about than Facebook and the beauty of algorithms. He is obsessed with his product.
Okay.
And I always find out that the young guys who are obsessed with their product, who have a vision, who are really monotematic, you have to watch them. When I first met Marissa Mayer, who is now the CEO of Yahoo, she was the girlfriend of Larry Page, and she spoke so quick and so fast, I hardly could understand her, but I could see, this was 1998, I could see something she has something. She is burning for an idea of making information available for everyone. Larry Page hardly speak anything, but she spoke so fast that we couldn't understand her, but I saw that she is really not an evangelist, she is burning, and I like this kind of people, and this is a pattern. Right now I'm very fascinated by a young guy, his name is Zach Sims. Who of you have heard from Zach Sims?
Zach Sims.
Watch out, heard? I promise a big future for him. He is doing something which you all should do, Code Academy. I think we should all should learn coding, because this is one of the key technologies of our century. And as long as you, who of you do know how to code? Some. We all should, I should, you should, everyone. Your kids should learn to code. And this young guy, Zach, he invented Code Academy. In January, he had 10 million users. Now he has already 30 million users. And I think we should get it into the schools of all our schools, our European or Italian schools, our German schools. We all should learn coding, because if we don't know how to code, we don't understand our society sooner or later anymore.
We were watching before.
I'm preaching, as you can see.
Yeah, it's true. We were watching before together, John, doing the speech before, and you see, technology is all over. So if you have the feeling and the knowledge about what's going on, it's much easier to move. What's your receipt to spot a talent? Before, I mean, what are the key elements that you watch? Because we were talking also before that for investors, for instance, the problem is that you have to invest in the people. You have to spot someone that you believe is talented, and you say, okay, I put money on this guy or on this lady. What's your
recipe? What's my recipe? Yeah. Let's do it other way.
Yeah.
Who of you is in business?
Come on, guys.
Come on, guys.
Who are you?
Who of you is in technology? Who of you has a vision? That's great. Come later. Let's talk. And who of you is in art? Too few. Should be much more. Art is a seismograph for changing things in society. And art is a catalysator. We are here in this beautiful maxi. It's amazing how inspiring it is. And I think the pattern for recognizing talent is find someone who has a vision, who talks about his vision, who has many messages to bring this vision out. Talk to him. Like the idea. Create enthusiasm with this guy. If you have the enthusiasm to promote the guy, it's good. Do it. So I think it's pattern recognition. It's always the same. Find the guy who has a vision, who has a good team, who is obsessed, who is a nice guy. Invest only in nice guys. Really, I tell you. If you don't like him, but you like the idea, it's not enough. You have to find the nice, good guys.
Nice, not like good looking. Like
yeah, not good. It helps. It helps.
Oh God! <Yeah. laughs> And tell me another thing. Community around DLD, you created a community. So I think that one of your top skill is. Spotting great talents immediately, so investing in people,
discovering people,
great people, and creating a community, connecting. I just tell you before to go on. I was in the speaker room with Steffi, and every time that someone is arriving, she connects immediately the other people. You know, so she's a live social network. I think that's my opinion. So it's one of your skills. How do you create this kind of community?
I tell you something. Yeah. I tell you a secret. I'm a very shy person. Really, I am. Okay. And in order not to talk too much to this or to her or to him, I rather connect them. You know, it's really. If you're shy, make it a profession. Connect people. It's a pattern. And also another thing I like very much is connect the unexpected. Many people are cooking their soup with their friends, and they don't look over the rim, you know. And sometimes people need a weak link from the outside. They need something they never heard of, strange things, curious things, weird things. And this connection, connect the unexpected. This is, for many people, it helps. And this I love to do.
Okay. So mixing also different, totally different sectors.
Yeah. For example, I have a good example. You saw in the little video Troy Carter. Troy is the manager of Lady Gaga, wonderful guy. And he was at DLD speaking of inventing Gaga. But we connected him to a lot of startup scene, to many startupists of, in the Silicon Valley. And he got over this music managing thing.
Right.
He got new ideas, he got new people, and now he's investing in a lot of interesting Atom Factory, a lot of interesting and ventures. So bring unexpected things together and create something new with
and
it.
And this is the right mix. Tell me again, I saw, for instance, the Deepak Chopra before, but I saw so many speakers, you know. If you want to get some, now it's easy because you just say, hey, come to DLD, so it's easy. But in the beginning, what did you do? I mean, you were just sending an email, calling. How did you convince someone, a great person, to come at your event?
Do you know who is Deepak Chopra?
Yes.
Good. Deepak is a wonderful spiritual man who combines medicine with meditation, with life coaching, with interesting things. He wrote many good books. And I think we live in a very technology-related world, so we need another world. We need a spiritual world is maybe too much, but we need two sides, technology and direct
another
reality.
Dimension.
Another dimension, that's the right one. And when I was young, I was a hippie, and I spent a year in a Buddhist cloister of the Tibetan monks. Now it's the Naropa Institute.
I would love to watch the pictures,
yeah,
Steffi.
Yeah, red hairs, and my mother didn't recognize me when I came back from the States. And I think we should emphasize on the other side of us. We should get our emotions, our spirituality, much more out of it. Because if we can combine it, we have an advantage.
And how did you convince, for instance, Deepak Chopra to come? or
I told
this kind
him,
of people?
Yeah, I told him that I like his books, and I think that all these Mark Zuckerbergs of the world have a need of spirituality. They're very successful. They earn tons of money, but at one point of their life comes up at one time of their life comes a point which they need something which is not it's not viable with money.
Yeah.
And Deepak comes in this.
Okay.
So he's teaching Lady Gaga, he's teaching Nikesh, he's a very influential man.
So basically you try to find an angle, to find the right point of contact to get the interest of the
Make new connections. Make new connections. Be open. Don't stay in your technology community. Don't stay in your business community. Don't invest in business plans. Invest in people. This will be a recipe for success.
Right. I love it. Invest in people. Guys, if you want to ask something to Steffi, we just have
a
couple of minutes more, so just feel free. I don't have a mic, but I'm coming to you, okay? You can speak with my mic. You ready?
Yeah. The question is, if you can tell us your...
Sorry, guys, that's embarrassing. Sorry,
ask,
that's real.
Okay,
we try.
Yeah, no, I don't think I need a mic.
Okay.
Yeah, if you can tell us your vision, one or two seconds.
So they can
my
hear
vision.
You, sorry.
Oh, my
yeah.
God.
Yeah,
my
because
vision.
You talk yeah. about it, like, yeah. say, do you have a vision?
I,
and
yeah,
it's always...
I tell you, I love happy people at my events. If they are happy and if they... create a business, if they create a marriage, if they create empathy and enthusiasm, I'm really happy. You know, maybe I was an inn owner, maybe I was a restaurant owner in former lives, I don't know, but I will be. It's not on money, it's on bringing together people for a new meaning. I think this is my vision, I love it. I think in our virtual world, we need to touch, we need to see each other. So our DLD is always very, very packed. People hardly have room to move. They have to touch, and they have to see each other, talk to each other. And my vision is to create this dialogue.
Yeah, because if I can be honest,
a little bit criticizing, like not for you, but the people think that you need to know like important people in order to do things, or you have to be already in a specific network, etc. So how could you like defeat this? Like, how could you get inside and start your own things just by convincing by yourself?
I didn't get that question. Sorry.
That if you, in order to do something big, that you need already to know people who are important.
So it's basically difficult to start from zero.
Yes.
Yeah.
Without the right connections.
I tell you, tell you something. I was not a good pupil. I switched schools like shirts. So this was the basement for my network. I know many people, and if you know many people, and if you have the gene to bring them together, either at a conference, either at a startup, it fits. And if you don't have the gene, find someone who make the connections for you.
Yeah, that's interesting. Can I tell you this funny story? I was a professional table tennis player, okay? And it's not a joke, this one, guys. It's serious. I was like playing table tennis when I was a kid, and I was just practicing. And then I decided to start work, but the only thing I could do was playing table tennis. So I remember one guy called me and said, Marco, do you want to come to work in my CAD company? Yeah. CAD, you know, electromechanical, electrotechnical, CAD, very tech stuff. And I said, man, I have no idea what you're talking about. And he said, if you are good in table tennis, you'll be good in doing this, you know? And I said, and I started like that. So it was a matter of connection. Didn't matter the sector, honestly, because he, let's say, invested in the person, not in the knowledge. So.
And what's behind it? Being open to the connections and to the change. Maybe I forgot to tell that I'm working for a traditional media company. And of course, it's essential for Hubert Burda Media to get in touch with all these change makers, with the disruptors. It's essential for our industry to be on the edge of progress. So there's behind my niceness and behind my community affinity and there is, of course, a hardcore business. I like to bring people together that they do business, that we have a chance to invest in the latest trends. So it's not only on being nice. It's being on the edge of developments and bring the people together. Thank you.
Right. Guys, Steffi Czerny, how about that? Steffi, thank you so much. Thank you so much. This way.